Hi, welcome to Mat3ra tutorial series once again. In this short video, we will give a glimpse of various ways of accessing our platform. There are three main ways to access our simulation platform, namely, the web interface using a browser, command line interface via SSH, and API access. These different modes of access are designed keeping in mind various use cases. For example, a novice user will probably find the web browser interface most user-friendly to run his or her DFT simulations, while an enterprise user might find our API access is suitable to integrate our services with their existing client application. However, these different modes of access are complementary to each other, and oftentimes, a user might want to use more than one mode or all three modes to interact with our platform, depending on the task at hand. First, let's have a look at our web interface. Use any modern browser and visit platform.mat3ra.com. Web interface is designed for both novice and experienced users. You should be able to run simulations without getting into various technicalities. Currently, our significant development effort is focused on the web platform. New features are being added more frequently. If you do not have an account already, please sign up for a new account. Please use your credentials to log in. Once you have logged in, you will see a dashboard with sections for your recent jobs, recent properties you have calculated, workflows, materials, projects, and so on. Depending on what task you want to carry out, you can visit one of those pages. For example, if I want to create an entry for a new material, we can visit the materials page. Here, we can import material structure or create new structure using Material Designer by specifying lattice type, lattice constants, atomic positions, etc. We can navigate to another page from the left sidebar, or use the top tab bar for navigation. You can have a look at the materials and workflows banks, contributed by the users of this platform. Discussing every feature of our web platform is not possible in this short video. Instead, I would suggest you to visit our YouTube channel and have a look at our recent tutorials. You can visit our YouTube channel using the short URL m3.lu/yt. Next, let's have a look at our command line interface via SSH. Before we are able to authenticate seamlessly for SSH connection, we need to set up our SSH keys. Please have a look into our documentation page at docs.mat3ra.com and search for SSH or visit this page directly by typing short URL m3.lu/d/SSH. Here you will find platform-specific step-by-step instructions. Once you have set up SSH keys, we can launch a terminal application and connect to Mat3ra login node by issuing this command, SSH, your username at login.mat3ra.com. Once you have connected, you will see some commonly used commands, such as exacluster that shows available clusters in your node. Similarly, exanodes command shows available nodes. Our queue system is managed by PBS, so any PBS command will work. For example, you can check the summary of your recently submitted jobs by qstat command or qsub to submit a new job. Various software versions are managed by environment modules. You can check available software modules by module avail command. We can see that default version of GCC is 4.8.5. If we want a newer version, we can use module load command. If you want to familiarize yourself with commonly used HPC commands, please have a look at our documentation pages. You can visit our GitHub repository CLI job examples, where you will find various application-specific examples. Besides, using SSH terminal application, our web platform also have a web terminal access and remote desktop feature, which does not require any SSH or remote desktop client installed. Finally, let's have a glance at our API access. With API, you can interact with our platform programmatically. The best place to find information about API would be our documentation pages. Our API Explorer, available at api-explorer.mat3ra.com, is helpful to test sample query and responses without writing any code. Another popular use case of our API access is among those using Python notebooks. Nowadays, Jupyter notebooks are popular for big data analysis. If your workflow involves Jupyter notebooks locally or on the cloud, such as Google Colab, you can run HPC jobs directly from your notebook via API. If interested, please visit our GitHub repository, API Examples. Here you will find various examples notebooks. For example, we can have a look at this notebook that runs a quantum espresso simulation. You will find how to set up a PI token, how to create and submit HPC jobs, monitor job status, and finally fetch the output files, and continue your data analysis on Jupyter Notebook. That's all for this short platform introduction. Now it's your turn to explore more. Thank you for following along.